Now you're unmuted.
Oh, okay. We'll have to watch it.
Come here, Amber. I'll show you how to.
Why is everyone muted?
Come over here.
Well, because it's.
Sometimes the church can mute everybody. Look, you touch in the black. See the mute and see the start of the movie? If you.
Good morning. Pentecost comes from a Greek word meaning 50th day. On this day, the Holy Spirit came with wind and flame, empowering the disciples to proclaim the good news on the risen Lord to all people. On the day of Pentecost, we give particular thanks for the gift of God's Holy Spirit, who gathers the church as the body of Christ and sends us to share in Christ's mission throughout the world. Good morning to those who are joining us in the sanctuary and also to those who are on Zoom. Let's join in the call to worship. Remember the promises of the Lord. God will pour out the Spirit on all flesh. On Pentecost, the church was born. We give thanks for the Holy Spirit, for the church universal, and for the celebration of confirmation. Come, Holy Spirit, we worship God together today. Please stand as you are able and join us in the first hymn, number 129, verses 1 and 2. O come, O Spirit.
Thank you.
Anyone who is thirsty, come to me. Out of the believer's heart shall flow rivers of living water. God's love for you is larger than you can imagine, and it flows through those life-giving waters. Trusting in God's grace and love, let us confess our sin, first in unison, and then in the silence of our hearts. Please join me as in the bulletin. Almighty God, you poured your spirit upon gathered disciples, creating bold tongues, open ears, and a new community of faith. We confess that we have lacked the force of your spirit among us. We do not listen for your word of grace, speak good news of your love, or live as a people made one in Christ. Have mercy on us, O God. Transform our timid lives by the power of your spirit, and fill us with a flaming desire to be your faithful people. Doing your will for the sake of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Through Christ, God has poured out the Holy Spirit upon us for the forgiveness of sins. Friends, know that you're made completely new through this gift and be at peace. In the name of Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. Thanks be to God. Amen. Would you please stand as you are able in body or spirit to join in the Gloria Patri. And through that love, we have been forgiven and made new. Let us share a sign of Christ's peace with one another. The peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you. And I would like to invite all the children forward, please. All of you.
You can sit wherever you can see the book. Okay? So
some ways. But this is called the children's time, or the time for young disciples. There's all different kinds of names for this. But basically, today I'm going to read you all a story. And this story is called the Pentecost story because today is Pentecost. I know that's kind of a long and fancy word, but that's okay. It's a church word, and it's just today. Today is Pentecost. It is 50 days after Easter. So that is what today is. Today is Pentecost. So I'm going to read you this story so you can learn a little bit more about Pentecost together. Sound good? Okay. Long ago in Babylon, when Earth was very young, the people all lived in one place. They spoke one common tongue. They didn't think they needed God's help or strength at all. They built themselves a city with a tower tall. Our tower touches the heaven, the people said with glee. We're awesome. We're so cool. There's nothing we can't be. So that's Babylon and the tower. The really, really tall tower. The Lord came down to see it, the tower that they made. He said, I'm so unhappy to know how far they've strayed. As long as they're one people and speak one language too, there won't be any limits to what humankind can do. They think that they don't need me. They're fine on their own. But this sin will be their downfall. They'll get nothing done alone. God scattered all the people through every single land and mixed up all their languages so they couldn't understand. That's why there are so many kinds of languages, color, and race. God spread out all his people through every land and place. So everybody was all together, and then they went to different places and had different languages, which is why we all speak different languages. Now, much, much later, God sent Jesus, his one and only son, to come and save the world from sin, to make us all be one. He died and rose to heaven and told us that he said the promise, Holy Spirit, our teacher and our friend, the Holy Spirit. The followers of Jesus were gathered in one place with folks from everywhere, from every land and race. The Holy Spirit blew down like a strong wind. He came and rested on all Jesus' friends as tiny tongues of flame. They all spoke of Jesus' love so everyone could hear, each in his own native language, in words both loud and clear. So you see all the people with like the little flames on their heads? Yeah? So that are the followers of Jesus, and they're getting the Holy Spirit. So the little flames are like the Holy Spirit. 3,000 people cry out, oh Lord, what should we do? Turn back, be baptized, Peter said, every one of you. The people did what Peter said, and so the church began. On that day called Pentecost, God's Spirit filled the land. The church began on Pentecost. God sends his Holy Spirit and will be one in love, sent out to tell his story, God's message from above. Since the Tower of Babel fell, our speech is not the same. On Pentecost, the Spirit made us one in Jesus' name. That's the end of the story. So Pentecost is a really big deal because it meant that everyone could understand one another. So there's like a powerful gift that was given so people could understand one another, even though they didn't speak the same language. And it's the birthday of the church. The whole church around the world today is its birthday, Pentecost. So that's kind of a fun thing. And in the day, we get to celebrate. We get to celebrate in many ways, including you all singing. So I'm going to pray for us, and then you guys get to sing. Sound good? Okay, let's pray. Dear God, we thank you so, so much for your love. We thank you for your gift of the Holy Spirit so that we can all be connected to you and united in Christ. God, help us to love you and all the people around us better and better. In your name we pray, amen. Okay, so now it's time for your song.
And settled there. And they said to one another, come, let's make bricks and burn them thoroughly. And they had brick for stone and bitumen for mortar. Then they said, come, let us build ourselves a city and a tower with its top in the heavens. And let us make a name for ourselves. Otherwise, we shall be scattered abroad upon the face of the whole earth. The Lord came down to see the city and the tower which mortals had built. And the Lord said, look, they are one people, and they have all one language, and this is only the beginning of what they will do. Nothing that they propose to do will now be impossible for them. Come, let us go down and confuse their language so that they will not understand one another's speech. So the Lord scattered them abroad from there over the face of all the earth, and they let off building the city. Therefore, it was called Babel, because there the Lord confused the language of all the earth. And from there, the Lord scattered them abroad over the face of all the earth. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thanks to God. second reading today comes from the book of Acts, chapter 2, verses 1 through 21. This might sound familiar given the story I just read to the children. When the day of Pentecost had come, they were all together in one place. And suddenly from heaven, there came a sound like the rush of a violent wind. And it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues as of fire appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak other languages as the Spirit gave them ability. Now, there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem. And at this sound, the crowd gathered and was bewildered because each one heard them speaking in the native language of each. Amazed and astonished, they asked, "Are not all these who are speaking Galileans? And how is it that we hear each of us in our own native tongue? Parthians, Medes, Elamites, and residents of Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and the parts of Libya belonging to Cyrene, and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabs, in our own languages we hear them speaking about God's deeds of power." All were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, "What does this mean?" But others sneered and said, "They are filled with new wine." But Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed them, "Men of Judea and all who live in Jerusalem, let this be known to you and listen to what I say. Indeed, these are not drunk as you suppose, for it is only 9 o'clock in the morning. No, this is what was spoken through the prophet Joel. In the last days it will be, God declares, that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. Even upon my slaves, both men and women, in those days I will pour out my spirit, and they shall prophesy. And I will show portents in the heavens above and signs on the earth below, blood and fire and smoky mist. The sun shall be turned to darkness and the moon to blood before the coming of the Lord's great and glorious day. Then everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved." This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. That was quite the unusual birthday celebration. But now to continue in this birthday celebration of the church, universal, we are going to invite the kids forward again for a very special moment in the lives of their Sunday school career. So all the kids who are part of our Sunday school, please come forward.
Okay, so we're up here to give out to recognize our Sunday school kids, and it was great to be back with regular Sunday school the whole year, and being able to meet every week again, having the Christmas pageant. So this year we have Molly Marquardt and Kaylee Marquardt are getting their first year certificates. Abigail Gulick and Emily Gulick are getting their third year certificates. Owen Tao is getting his fourth year. Emmeline Demeter is also getting her fourth year. Avon Schwartz and Heath Sicardi are getting their fifth year. August Sicard is getting his sixth year. Molly Schwartz is getting her seventh year. And Eloise Demeter is getting her ninth year. Okay. Here, Owen. Hey, good job, guys.
Thank you, Sunday School. I think we all share in the rejoicing, that is the ability to come together and worship together and learn together, things we all took for granted in 2019 and before. So it's a joyous time to see all the children and to celebrate them on this day where we celebrate the birthday of the church. And I don't know about you all, but I think a great way to celebrate is also to not just celebrate the youngest children in our congregation, but also to celebrate our confirmants. And so today, it is not only the Pentecost, not only is it the end of the Sunday school year, it is also Confirmation Sunday. So I'd love to invite our confirmants forward to the chancel. Good job. Okay, Owen Demeter, Kira Lewis, and Bailey Tao are presented by the session for the reaffirmation of their baptismal covenant made on their behalf when they were younger. They now desire to profess their faith publicly and to accept greater responsibility in the life of the church and God's mission in the world. Confirmants, we rejoice with you now that you have the desire to declare your faith and to share with us in our common ministry. In baptism, we were joined to Christ and made members of Christ's body. In the community of the people of God, you have learned of God's purpose for you and for all of creation. You have been nurtured at the table of our Lord and called to witness to the gospel of Jesus Christ. You are citizens with the saints and members of the household of God, built upon the foundation of apostles and prophets, with Christ Jesus himself as the cornerstone. So, I will now ask you the questions where you're going to be professing your faith. For those of you in the congregation, you may follow along for their questions in the, greenish colored insert. Okay, trusting in the gracious mercy of God, do you turn from the ways of sin and renounce evil and its power in the world? And who is your Lord and Savior?
Jesus Christ is my Lord and Savior.
Will you be Christ's faithful disciple, obeying his word and showing his love? Will you devote yourself to the church's teaching and fellowship, to the breaking of bread and the prayers? Great, wonderful. Would you all please join me in prayer? Gracious God, by water and the Spirit, you claimed us as your own, cleansing us from sin and giving us new life. You made us members of your body, the church, calling us to be your servants in the world. Renew in Bailey and Kira and Owen the covenant you made in their baptism. Continue the good work you have begun in them. Send them forth by the power of your Spirit to love and serve you with joy and to strive for justice and peace in all the earth. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And now, having heard that they have affirmed their faith, let us all affirm our faith together using the words of the Apostles' Creed. So please stand as you are able in body or in spirit. And the Apostles' Creed is printed in the bulletin for those who may like to follow along with it. So, Church, what is it that you believe?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and
and Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Amen. Amen. Now, people who are not direct family of our confirmands, you may be seated. And then if you are direct family of the confirmands, I would invite you forward for our next laying on of hands prayer, if you feel so comfortable. You may go to your own child / loved one. And what a beautiful sight this is. Okay. Would you all please lay your hands on your loved ones? There we go. We want them to feel the community that loves them so much. And would you all please pray with me? Oh Lord, uphold Owen and Kira and Bailey by your Holy Spirit. Daily, O God, increase in them your gifts of grace, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, the spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever. Amen. Bailey, Kira, and Owen, remember your baptism and be thankful. And know that the Holy Spirit is at work within you. Thanks be to God. Amen. Okay, family, you may head back to your seats. We're almost through. Okay. I don't know about, they couldn't see this, but I thought that was incredibly powerful. So I know some people got some photos. You're going to see it on the YouTube video later, so you all can see that moment as well. So, Bailey, Kira, and Owen, by professing your faith publicly, you have expressed your intention to grow in the covenant of God that God made with you in your baptism. May the Spirit continue to strengthen and sustain you in the worship and mission of the church. Alleluia. Amen. Okay, so as an official welcome to the church, we also have a gift for each of you. For Owen, and Kira, and Bailey. Now, all of the things in that bag kind of go together. And the biggest gift that any of us can think to give is God's word. So you each have your own Bible. And there are some things in the book, in the package, that kind of can go along with that to help you in your Bible study. So there's some things, and I don't want to spoil all the surprise, but there's some stuff in there to help you center yourself and keep your place as you're reading through the Bible. Sound good? Okay, wonderful. Let's clap and celebrate them and welcome them. Okay. I do want to say, as they are making their way back down, that I had such a wonderful year getting to know our confirmands and getting to just be a part of their faith journey. And so it was such a pleasure. And teaching confirmation is definitely one of my favorite parts of being a pastor. So I'm so glad that we got to finish up that. that process today in such a wonderful celebratory way. So you may now take it away.
Now is the time when we share our joys and concerns. And after each joy or concern, we would say, God have mercy, hear our prayer. So if we could start out in the sanctuary, if anybody has a joy or concern they want to share. Go ahead.
I feel someone special at the church with me today. Joy that is out in the hospital.
Okay.
Thank you very much for your cards and prayers. While I was in the hospital, which is a world-renowned hospital in Philadelphia, I lost 8 pounds. And you might wonder why. It had nothing to do with the operation at all. But I couldn't eat the food. Incredibly bad. Even Donna couldn't eat it. I asked one of the nurses there in passing, did they go to a special school to learn to cook food this bad? Other than that, I think I did fairly well. And again, I thank you for everything.
We're glad to have you back. God have mercy for your parents. Anyone else?
My prayers for Shelley's family, and especially your husband, John.
God have mercy to hear our prayer. Be in joy for concerns. Is there anything on Zoom? Okay.
Well, whose family was that?
Pardon me?
Whose family did you ask for prayer for?
Shelley, who died recently and unexpectedly. She was a good friend of my all of a sudden, Greg.
Thank you. I've been away for 2 weeks, so I feel like I'm in the shuffle. Okay. Chris Sarno reached out to me with two prayer requests as well. The first is that Chuck Sarno is having an MRI this week. And so we will definitely be keeping them in our prayers as he goes through that to see. If you might remember, he's having, I think it's a hip or a knee issue. And so he's having an MRI for that. Also, their second thing is both a joy and a request. Nikki Sarno, their daughter, is getting married this coming Saturday. And so that's a celebration indeed. The request is that their ceremony is outside. So if we can pray for things to go smoothly is what Chris asked for us. So with these prayers, requests shared, let us join our hearts together. Spirit of the living God, you surround us and fill us with yourself. You guide us and set our feet upon the right path. Help us, O God, to be more aware of the needs of others and to be more often, more continually in prayer. For the power of the Holy Spirit is indeed strong within all of us. For the Spirit is your gift to all your followers. And on this, the birthday of the Church Universal, we pray, O God, for your church. We pray that we can all be united based on Christ's ministry that we're called to continue as his followers. May we be united in our pursuit of justice, peace, compassion, and service. May we set aside the things that divide us so that we can take up the things that build us up as Christ's body in this world. Merciful God, we're constantly surrounded by negative news, by tragedy. Some we hear and some we don't. We pray for all of those impacted by the recent gun violence in our country, from Buffalo, New York, to Laguna Woods, California, to Uvalde, Texas, to Tulsa, Oklahoma. God, we lift up the families of the victims as they continue to mourn the death of those they love so dearly who died in such a senseless way. Loving God, we know that you created us to be connected and you desire for us to be united in our love for you and our fellow humans. We pray for our leaders. May they put aside petty differences and work instead together for the good of this country, so that this country can be and continue to be a shining example of your will in this world. Gracious God, we also pray for those closer to home, for those we know ourselves. We pray for those who need your healing touch and comforting support. We pray especially for Chuck as he goes in for his MRI. God, may the results show the way forward to further healing. We pray for Shelly's family as they mourn her unexpected death. We also pray for those joyful things to share and uplift. And so we thank you, O God, for moments of joy, especially for the upcoming wedding of Nikki. We pray that the ceremony and celebration go as smoothly as possible as Nikki begins a new chapter of her life. And we give you thanks, O God, for Bob being back from his surgery and his hospital stay. And we thank you for the gift of community that surrounded him in prayer. And we thank you that he is doing well and that we get to see him today. God, you alone know the entire story, and we can only see pieces of the puzzle. Help us, O God, in times of certainty and in times of confusion, to always seek you and your will for us first. We thank you for the gift of the church to bring us together and to explore your holy word for us through scripture and community. We also thank you, O God, for the gift of prayer, and especially for the Lord's Prayer, which we will now pray together, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. It is now almost our time for our offering. And so before we take that up, I'm going to be sharing a minute for mission with all of you. As you may know today, well, as I've said several times, today is Pentecost. And in the PCUSA, which is the denomination we're part of, there are special offerings, one of which is taken on Pentecost. So we'll be taking that offering today. And so the minute for mission today is about building a life of faith. The branches of their family trees are filled with Presbyterian pastors and elders. So it's no wonder that Akilah Hirams and Noah Westfall, both alums of the PCUSA's Young Youth Adult Volunteer, or YAV, program, have lives rooted in their faith-building experiences. The YAV program is an ecumenical, faith-based year of service for young people ages 19 through 30 in sites across the United States and around the world. YAVs accompany local agencies working to address root causes of poverty and reconciliation. Alongside this work, volunteers explore the meaning of their Christian faith and accountability to their neighbors in the community, with peers and mentors. The YAV program is supported in part through the Pentecost offering. The offering also supports Youth Triennium and the Educate a Child, Transform the World National Initiative. 40% of the offering is retained by individual congregations like ours. And this year, the 40% will be going to help with any of the costs associated with our VBS program. And the VBS program will be taking place in August. So 40% of the offering taken up today will go to help with that, while the other 60% is used to support children at risk, youth and young adults through various ministries by the Presbyterian Mission Agency. When it comes to what our gifts to this Pentecost offering can do, perhaps Akilah says it best, When you donate, you're supporting someone through a life-changing experience, which looks different for everyone. These experiences open our eyes and broaden our horizons. Thank you for any support you can give. You'll never know how much it truly means to each and every one of us. Today is the day, as I said, that we as Presbyterians collect the Pentecost offering. So please use the little Pentecost offering envelopes if you so choose to give in this way. Please pray with me. Great physician, heal our communities by your grace and raise up leaders in every field who seek your hope, wholeness, and well-being for this your world. Amen. Friends, all that we have comes from God. So let us give back to our Lord and Savior out of gratitude and thanksgiving for the ways we've been blessed. We also offer our special Pentecost offering for the benefit of the local children and for other children, youth, and young adults who will benefit directly from these donations. Use these gifts of God to build your kingdom here on earth. I would like to invite the ushers. Would you all please stand if you are able and join in the doxology together.
Generous God, you came down to the world as your Son, Jesus Christ, and as your Spirit in tongues of fire. We thank you for the gifts of connection with you. Use these gifts, which we now offer back to you, as a sign of our commitment to your way for our lives. Help us, O God, to be more and more generous. In Christ's name and in the power of the Holy Spirit, we pray. Amen.
You may be seated. It is now the time in our service where we will come together to partake in communion. And for the first time in a very long time, those of us in the sanctuary, we will be passing the plate with the communion elements. If you would rather have an all-in-one Jesus, we can also have that be given to you as well. Okay, so friends, the people will come from north and south and from east and west to sit at table in the kingdom of God. Now, when our risen Lord was at table with two of his disciples, he took bread and he blessed and he broke it and he gave it to them. And that is when their eyes were opened and they recognized him. Friends, this is our Lord's table. And those at home, the Lord's table is your table as well. And our Savior invites all those who trust in him to share in the feast which he has prepared. So friends, the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
Please pray with me. It is truly right and our greatest joy, O God, to give you thanks and praise. Your spirit hovered over the waters and brought forth all creation. You breathed into us the breath of life and set us on the earth to praise and serve you. We lost our way, you called us back, and then sent your Son to save us. Therefore, eternal God, we praise you, joining our voices with choirs of angels and with all the faithful of every time and place who forever sing to your glory. We thank you for Jesus, our Savior and Lord. By your Spirit, you named him beloved and empowered him to serve the poor, proclaim freedom from sin's bondage, and befriend the friendless and the outcast. When he breathed his last upon a cross, you raised him from the tomb, breaking the power of death and opening the way to eternal life. God, remembering all your mighty and merciful acts, we take this bread and this juice from the gifts that you have given us and celebrate with joy the redemption won for us in Jesus Christ. Accept this, O God, as our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, as a living and holy offering of ourselves, that our lives may proclaim the one crucified and risen. Gracious God, pour out your Holy Spirit upon us and upon these your gifts of bread and cup. Unite us with Christ and with all those who trust in him, that we may be one in ministry in every place. As this bread is Christ's body for us, send us out to be the body of Christ in the world. God, set our hearts aflame with a love for the truth and desire to do your will. Make our witness to Christ burn brightly and keep us faithful until Christ comes in final victory, and we shall feast with all your saints in the joy of your eternal realm. Through Christ, all glory and honor are yours, Almighty God, with the Holy Spirit in the Holy Church, now and forever. Amen. On the night when our Lord and Savior was going to be denied, betrayed, and arrested, before that happened, he was at dinner with his friends and his disciples. And while he was at dinner, he, after giving thanks, he took the bread and he broke it. And he gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And in the same way, he took the cup, saying, "This cup is the sign of the new covenant, sealed in my blood, shed for you for the forgiveness of sin." For as the Apostle Paul tells us, as often as we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the saving death of our risen Lord until he comes again. The table is now ready. I would like to invite those who are serving communion to please come down.
Thank you.
Given for you. Please pray with me once more. Gracious God, may we who receive this sacrament live in the unity of your Holy Spirit, that we may show forth your gifts to all the world. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Like I said, this is our first time doing this in a really long time. We remembered some things today. Okay, so now time for announcements. The first announcement I wanted to make was that before worship, I played a video that Ashley Zaccardi spent a lot of time making. I'll be playing it again after the postlude. So if you want to watch it again, you may. It'll be played again. And the other...
It'll be on the worship video on our YouTube page.
There was supposed to be a deacons meeting on Tuesday. That will need to be rescheduled. So all deacons, be looking for a message to reschedule our last meeting before we take the summer hiatus. So that will be rescheduled. So just keep an eye out for that rescheduling. If you show up at Green Valley Farm 6 p.m. on Tuesday, I'm sure you can buy ice cream. There just won't be a meeting happening at the same time. Okay, any other announcements we'd like to share? Yes, go ahead, Walt.
We haven't had the choir here for a while, but if you want to hear most of the choir, Donna, do you want to pick it up?
Okay. Excuse me. This afternoon at 3 o'clock, the Sussex County Choral Society will be giving a spring concert. And Walt and I and Steve are going to be singing it. It's a couple of our members who are not able to come because of illness or whatever. So if you're in for a real treat, we have a songs.
Okay, so that's the Sussex Choral Society at 3 p.m. where?
Oh, sorry. At the Hamburg Baptist Church.
Okay, at the Hamburg Baptist Church, 3 p.m. if you would like something to add to your afternoon schedule.
I just want to say if you do come as early as possible because parking is limited.
Parking is limited, she said. So if you want to come, you might want to come early. Okay, I think that was all the announcements I wanted to share with the community today. So with that, would you all please stand as you are able and join in our final hymn, number 521, verses 1, 2, and 5.
Thank you.
the world to celebrate not only the birthday of the church, but the gift of the Holy Spirit, which is among each and every one of us to connect us both to Christ and to one another. And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you now and forever. Amen.
Thank you.
Congratulations.